Hello students, so once again a warm and beautiful good morning to everyone. Moving with our English language class, today we will be having short writing task. And this means that we will be going to discuss our question number 3. In our paper, this short writing task will belong to question number 3. And in this question number 3, you are supposed to attempt any one question out of the given two short answer questions. And every question will cater will fetch 4 marks for you. And that will be based upon, either there will be notice writing, poster writing, formal and informal invitation and reply writing, even advertisements writing. The first most phenomenal, even specific aspect of a short writing task is that whatever that will belong to your short writing task has to be drawn, has to be written, has to be depicted, or has to be accomplished within a box. It means our short writing task, our question number 3 in the paper, will need a box to be written the answer. So moving with notice and the basic definition of notice, that what does a notice mean? Students, as with the displayed picture, you are having the definition and just pay attention on that. A notice is a written or printed announcement. Just listen to it again. A notice is a written or printed announcement. It means it can be either written, it can be either printed. Either there will be written notice or there will be printed notice. But it will be a kind of announcement, a kind of universal announcement that you will make, that you will write, that you will get printed. Okay? For the universal approach, it is written in order to inform a large number of people about something that has happened or is about to happen. Okay? It means a notice is to create an access, an approach to the people, to the public, to a specific group or to some specific people about something that either has happened or that will happen. Even it can be an upcoming event, competition also. That means whenever we will be going to have something in a upcoming future, and we want to make the people aware and get informed about this, so that we will be having the basic mode of communication, and that will be the notice. Notices are written in a formal tone. Notices are factual and to the point. Now students, be acquainted with this thing. Notices are factual and to the point. There will be no ornamental language, there will be no elaborations, there will be no explanations of any kind of things. But with the facts and up to the point, you are supposed to abridge or summarize your sentences in such a way that all the information and the facts about the information can be covered and can be given and can be written and can be printed. And when we talk about the format for notice writing, the format of a notice should include name of the institution, public issuing authority, notice, title, date, and writer's name with designation. Students, there must be the 5, the magical 5, the 5 things that are supposed to be found, supposed to be written, supposed to get printed, the time when you will be supplying, the time when you will be issuing any notice. And the first one will be name of the issuing agency, school. If the notice is given by the school, if the notice is given by any kind of authorities, any kind of agencies, then there must be the name of that particular institute, that particular agency. Date of issue, release of the notice. This is that give an authentication to your notice that yeah, it has been displayed, it has been circulated on that particular date. Then title, subject of the event, what? We are supposed to deliver, a piece of information in such a universal way. So there must be, a spectrum of highlight, and the highlight will indicate the title, the highlight will indicate the essence of our event or our competition. And then the 4th one, your notice language that will be carrying or that will be consisting of date, time, duration, place, venue, when and where. These are a few questions that are to be answered while in your notice format. And then at the end, there will be authorized signatory, contact details. You must write down your name or else you must put up your initials with your contact details. And with this the name, there must be the signature, there must be your designation also, that who has circulated this notice and the person who has circulated, what kind of designation he or she is having. And now a few more things that you must be having in your mind while you are writing your notice and while you are attempting for this question number 3, consisting of your notice as one part. This is students, all the 5 points that we discussed earlier, these 5 points must be within the box and they must be in such a specific way of the arrangement where every teacher can find that it has been written by a class 12th student. And there must be a strict pattern of arranging the sentences and arranging your phrases in a specific way that they must disclose the best and finest output. Even CBSE will be flexible to assist you with your writing task if it is not defiled or it is not deformed. That means your name of the institution should be at the top and it should be having your center alignment, and then leave a line and either at your right or your center or your left, but there must be the date. And the format of the date, students, can democratically be used, but while applying for the dates and writing for the dates, you are supposed to be familiar with the rightness of your dates format. Because if you write FEB, there must be dot instead of comma. And after that, 21, 22, 13, okay, 01, 02, whatever, then there should be comma. Because after, the pause, the comma must be there. Instead of the abbreviated part, there should be no comma. And then your year must be. So it will be like FEB dot 26, 2019-2020. And if you write a full February, January, March, April, whatever, if you write the full spelling of your month, there should be no dot, there should be no comma. March 21, comma. Because after this, March 21 is a complete unit. And after this unit, when you create a pause, then the comma is required. And then again, you may leave a line and you can write down your title and you can your subject of the upcoming event or of the event that had happened, okay, in between the central alignment only, okay. Then we will be having from the left alignment our body, our matter of the notice within the specific word limits of only 50 words. Because if you exceed your word limit, then it may lead to the reduction of the marks. Then after the accomplishment of your contents for your notice, at the end, from the same left alignment, there will be authorized signatory. That means there must be the signature of the authorized person who is issuing or circulating the notice, then his name and his designation. Even with another image, as we are having some notice writing tips, that means do not cross the word limit to avoid penalty of marks. Repetition of any information should be avoided. Always enclose the notice in a box. Make sure you draw the box with a pencil. Keep your notice short, crisp, and to the point. Highlight the word notice and title. It can be either bold or underlined. The title should be captivating and eye-catching. That means the essence of your contents must be caught in your title. Don't make hypothetical information and facts. Make use of what is given in the question. Again, there should be no application from your own side. Whatever data and facts which are given in the questions are supposed to be covered within the notice only. Make sure you do not mention your personal information. Make use of all the available information in the question. Your answer shall include answers to all the 5 W's. That means in the notice contains these 5 W's must be answered. What, why, when, where, and who. The purpose for which it is being written should be stated clearly. Focus on presentation and clarity. Again, I am saying you students, it must be looking while you are displaying your notice that it has been written by a class 12 students. It should be having no defilement, no deformation, no contamination with the language, and the handwriting should be legible, even the drawn of the box with the ruler with the help of the pencil. And when you talk about the categorization of the marks that will give you, there will be the format that will give you 1 mark, the contents for the 2 marks, and your expression for 1 mark. Contents, that mean whatever questions were raised in your notice. have been written or have been answered in the matter in the body. And then expression, your language proficiency, your spellings, and beyond that, what kind of words selection that you made.